Hey everyone, it's Scott from CertMedia.com, and in this video I'm going to be answering a question of whether you should use Breeze by CloudWays. The answer is no. Thank you so much. No, I'm just kidding. No, this plugin is really terrible. On an order of magnitude that I'm really going to drill into it a little bit. If you just want to know if you should use it, the answer is no. If you're looking for a free alternative, use Autoptimize and Cache Enabler. Or if you're looking for a paid alternative, use WP Rocket. But if you want to sit through and watch why you shouldn't use this plugin, well, sit down, because this is going to be very rude to this plugin. I love CloudWays. It's honestly saved me quite a bit of money, and I've gotten a lot better performance out of it since I've migrated. But this plugin is really bad. It's outdated, it's not well supported, or at least that I can see, and it's just a headache waiting to happen. So let's go ahead and jump into it. The Breeze by CloudWays plugin is basically what was old school WordPress Rocket based on version 2. Whatever. It has the old style user interface. Most of the options are ripped from the plugin, as you can kind of see. And it's just not very good. And WordPress Rocket back then wasn't all that good either. They really cleaned themselves up after version 3. But version 2 is just not good. And this plugin has not been updated to look like anything like that. So the first option you have is what turns on the plugin. It allows the cache system to work and to build the internal page cache system. The great thing about this plugin is it does also work with the Varnish cache system that CloudWays comes with standard. The next option is to purge the cache after, and then it's the amount of minutes. So 1440 minutes is 1 day or 24 hours. General recommendation set to 10 hours if you have a fairly complicated website. If not, by all means, set it to a higher interval if you don't update very frequently. Then we're going to hop into the minification. And this is where all the good things begin to come crumbling down. The minification plugin feature in this plugin, for the lack of a better word, sucks. It is not well made. It is not well developed. It has a lot of weird features that just don't work. And I'm going to go through and explain all of them. So the first option, the HTML checkbox, minifies the HTML. The CSS minification is the second box. The JS minification is the same thing. It'll minify the JS. The include inline JS will minify it, and the include CSS will minify it. With the JS, the gzip compression feature will enable gzip compression for your files. The browser cache headers will allow your CSS, your JS, and your images, and so on and so forth, to be cached. And enabling the cache for logged in users should never be checked. I'm only doing it to show you how bad this plugin really is. Let's jump into the minification again, because that's really the one thing that matters in most of these plugins. We are going to save and we are going to look at what's going on here. So I have the include inline CSS option enabled. And I also have the grouping feature enabled. And I'm going to turn that off because We're gonna start getting into these features, and we're gonna see some really weird things start to happen. So what's great is if you have the minification feature turned on, the inline CSS does get minified. As you can see here, this is on one line, and this is one line, even though it's usually several. That feature works as expected. And then you can choose to include the inline JS. So as you can see, I have this emoji script here that's default to WordPress core. So I chose the include inline JS option. And then it disappears. Where does it go? Well, it looks like it chooses to merge it down somewhere in the footer along with other inline JS. They just get moved to a file. The problem I have with this is you can minify an inline JS script without merging it. And sometimes merging inline JS leads to breakages. Common issues are with sliders. If you merge inline JS from a slider, like revolution slider, layer slider, so on and so forth, it will break. So without having the merging feature enabled, which is the group files feature, we're already going to be running into issues if you want to minify the inline JavaScript. So we're going to uncheck the inline JS option. Now, as we just saw, the include inline CSS option minifies the CSS, and that works perfectly well. However, if you go to the grouping feature and you choose to group your CSS files, so you want to combine your CSS files into as few files as possible, you're now going to have a weird thing where all the inline CSS is now merged into one CSS file. Now, inline CSS by its default is not a good thing. It should always be in a file if it can be, but most of the time plugins leave it there as a way of overriding CSS conflicts that are in your files. So if you merge it like this, you may have some display issues. The problem is you can't minify your inline CSS without also grouping it. I have no idea why that's the thing. The featured notes do not mention anything like that. It's to group CSS and JS files, not inline scripts, not inline styles, just files. But it decides to go ahead and do it anyways. Totally fine. So what we'll do is we'll just uncheck the include inline CSS option. Let it reload. And it's back. So, okay, we cannot combine our inline CSS without it. We cannot minify our inline CSS without it also being combined. Now we're going to go to the grouping file, the grouped files feature. And the grouped files feature has weird interactions. As you just saw, that nice giant script for the emoji JS was just merged into the JS file, and I have no idea why. Because as we saw with our include inline CSS option, if this is checked, that file gets merged. But the include inline JS option goes ahead and merges it anyways, and it seems to do so a little bit indiscriminately. It basically vaporized everything except for our customize script right here. I have no idea why it's decided to do this to me, but it does. And you just kind of have to live with that. Now, say you want to go ahead and exclude that. Well, you can exclude JS, and as the option notes, use this option to exclude JS files from minification and grouping. Does not at all mention inline script. So let's go ahead and just type in the word emoji. See what happens. We're gonna go over here, and you're going to not see those nice little scripts come back. They are gone. They are vaporized to never be seen from again. Because you have to declare a URL, as you see. So it's gone ahead and merged the inline JS with no way of disabling that feature. So you're just gonna have to live with it or not use the grouping feature. But as I have proven in time and time again, merging JS files, even when you have HTTP 2 or HTTP 3, it's still oftentimes just faster because WordPress themes are very redundant and most of the times they use a lot of the same code from different libraries. So you can never exclude the inline JS that's being merged. All right, that's fine. But what about files? So we have a file right here to move to exclude the wp-embed.min.js file. We wanted to move that file to the footer. We did not want it to be combined. And I only picked that file because I wanted an example. Now, here's the thing. That file is not moved to the footer, and it is also most certainly not deferred. Why is it that way? Because we have the grouping feature on. So naturally, if you don't want the file to be merged, you just come over and we're gonna paste the file into the exclude JS section. We have the URL, and if you exclude it, it should no longer be minified or combined. But that's fine, because we're just gonna move it to the footer, and we're going to defer it. This happens a lot with more complicated builders, where you have JS files that when they're merged or minified, they break, but they are able to be deferred. And instead what happens is, because we've excluded it up here, we cannot move it to the footer or defer it. So it's now just stuck there, render blocking forever, unless we turn off the grouping feature. And then that sends us back to square one. So let's turn off the grouping feature, and we still have the JS minification enabled. So now we come over here and let's just see. Okay, it looks like it's good. And would you look at that? It's still not moved to the footer. So you will never be able to exclude a file from being minified and grouped, but to also be deferred using this plugin. This happens a lot, more than I would can count, but you're just stuck with it because the plugin's interface and the way it's built is not meant to handle anything outside of the most basic of limitation. If you want to exclude a URL from being cached, that is honestly the easiest thing. This works without a problem, but everything that has to do with the minification system, not good at all. Not good, do not recommend it. Do not collect $200, do not pass go, do not even look at, and do not even give this thing another thought. But if you are really determined to use it, it has the database feature. It's very simple. It will remove the data as it says, and it does not have any means of scheduling. almost every other plugin that does this, except WP Sweep, which has the most cleanup options of any plugin I've ever tested, has some sort of way of scheduling. This does not. It's you just click it and you run it. And then I'll give it credit. This does work as expected. You let it reload and it will clean up the data. Unfortunately, you can't schedule it. So if you want to do it, you have to do it manually. You can't do it once a week. You can't do it once a month. You have to remember. I would never remember to run these things with how many sites I have to maintain, and even the ones of my own, just to go ahead and go in there and clean out the junk. I have it scheduled for a good reason. So this is also not that good of a feature. Lazy loading, non-existent. Does not exist in here. You have no option for it, so don't even think about it. But you do have a CDN feature, like every other plugin. Very simple. If you have a CNAME provided to you from a CDN provider, so if you're using StackPath, you just get the CNAME, you paste it in here, and you enable the top option. You can choose what folders to include, and then you can choose any file types that you wish to exclude. I recommend disabling the relative path because you should always use absolute URLs when you can. You want to make sure that you're using the absolute URLs to avoid some kind of weird SEO issue. Yoast actually has an article that they went over this, but always use absolute when you can. I don't really see why you'd use relative anyways. If you have an SSL, your whole site's gonna be SSL, and your assets should be served that way, so you shouldn't really need to use this in the first place. And then the only other option is to auto-purge the Varnish cache system. That's it, that is the entire plugin. What do I like about this plugin, since I have to be fair? The logo is pretty good. It has an FAQ section to answer questions because you are definitely going to run into some. Notably, if you use multi-sites, it has a nice little answer here. They're now handled at the network level. But everything else, pretty substandard at best. Do not recommend you use this plugin. Use anything else. Use Cache Enabler. Use WP Supercache. If you have the 16 hours it takes, set up W3 Total Cache and or use Autoptimize with any of those other plugins, and you'll just get a better job with more modern features, and you don't really lose anything from doing it. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask. CloudWays is still a great host. This is just a really useless caching plugin. Thank you so much for watching, and goodbye.